problem is that 140 characters or a comment to another journalist on the phone doesn't give people a clear picture, allies, adversaries, the American people, a clear picture of what you're trying to do. One thing it doesn't tell us, for instance, is that we're already undergoing an upgrade to our nuclear arsenal to the tune of billions of dollars.
David Drucker, I'll just read it for people who have missed his tweet. I'll just read it so everybody knows what we're talking about. The United States must greatly strengthen and expand its nuclear capability until such time as the world comes to its senses regarding nukes. How do you interpret that?
How do I interpret that? I have no idea how to interpret that. Let me tell you what it could mean. It could mean that we need to upgrade our nuclear arsenal and make it more modern. The infrastructure has had a huge problems and has been lagging behind. We know that from
But we're in the middle of that. I mean, as David Cerulich just said, we're already doing it.
Right.
Yes?
Right. But I mean, you're asking me basically to shrink the president-elect, and I'm not inside of his head. I'm not sure if he's trying to send a message to Putin or to North Korea or to China about the fact that we're not going to back down and we will continue to use our nuclear arsenal as a deterrent. Doing so has worked very effectively over years in American history. It's one of the reasons we won the Cold War. We were able to outlast the Russians both militarily and financially because they could not keep up. So it could mean all of these things. The reason we're all in, you know, sort of trying to figure this out is the president-elect has been on every side of this issue throughout the campaign and even up until now. At times he's talked about allowing other countries to have their own nuclear arsenals, countries that currently do not, and that we have, as a matter of policy, both Republicans and Democrats have always found it better for us to be in control of nuclear weapons and not even other democracies that we deal with. And now he's talked about wanting to get rid of nuclear weapons. Now he's talking about a buildup. This is the sort of thing that would be helpful for our allies and even domestically, our policymakers, to understand exactly what he's talking about. There could be positive aspects to this. There could be negative aspects to this. We just don't know.
And again, as this gets out that he said on the phone, let it be an arms race, we'll outmatch them at every pass. Let's wait until we hear from his people what the context was. Because again, sometimes even a president-elect or a president can speak one way to a friend on the phone and not mean it as a policy statement. But we don't know yet, so we'll have to learn more about that. Here's one that's more clear, where you don't have to shrink his head, as you say, David, but you can go on facts. He sent a couple of tweets about his son and his son's charitable efforts in the context of what was just revealed as, I don't know, a potential sham around the inauguration. My wonderful son Eric will no longer be allowed to raise money for children with cancer because of a possible conflict of interest with my presidency. Isn't this a ridiculous shame? He loves these kids, has raised millions of dollars for them, and now must stop. Wrong answer. Now, Mr. Cerulich, this is untrue on its face. One, there is no possible conflict of interest. There are real conflicts of interest. And what was revealed by the Center for Public Integrity about this invitation saying 500 grand to hunt with the boys, $1 million to get to meet the president, is not about raising money for kids. It was supposed to go to conservation charities, according to the invitation. What do you make of these tweets? Defending the son, of course, but this way.
Right. So it's understandable that Trump is going to sort of lash back at the criticism that these conflicts of interest exist and that the press is following up on these. I think here's the bigger picture challenge for the Trump transition, the administration, and the Trump kids. When Donald Trump was campaigning for president, he put out there a very basic idea that I think most people can go along with. He was going to run the country. His kids were going to run the Trump organization. There was going to be separation. But when you have these instances where the Eric Trump Foundation is raising money, say, for instance, auctioning off a coffee with Ivanka Trump or some of the other instances that you pointed out, this blurs the lines. As you said, there are not, you know, just sort of pretend conflicts of interest. Conflicts of interest are real, and this presents a problem for them, and they're now trying to push
back.
You
can raise money for kids all day. It's a beautiful thing to do. You just don't want to do it by selling access to the president.
Right. David Drucker, very quick thought.
Yeah, look, this is one of my favorite games. What if Clinton did it? This was the argument that the Clinton Foundation and their supporters made, and Trump, of course, was quick to point out and call it pay to play. It's all a sham. And everybody knows that Trump's kids are not just his kids. They're grown adults, number one. Number two, they're among his key advisors, his closest advisors. People are going to give to anything they do because they want access to the president, and to try and sell it as otherwise is just disingenuous. His supporters will buy it. It just simply isn't true.
David Cerulich, David Drucker, thank you very much. All right, coming up, we are monitoring two big breaking stories. The suspected Christmas market terrorist has been killed in a shootout in Milan. We'll tell you what happened and how police finally zeroed in on him. Then we're also watching this apparent plane hijacking, a plane leaving Malta. No, it's been diverted to Malta,
I should say. It was a Libyan flight internal to Libya.
This
was diverted to Malta by hijackers.
On the tarmac in Malta, we'll tell you what we know about what's happening on that plane next.